Oops, kids are back. Sorry guys, I wanted to interrupt this video.
Dad, you already been here?
Yep, I'm here. Cool.
And can we watch a movie?
You wanna watch a movie?
Huh?
Okay.
Are you drawing
live? Yeah. No. Sorry.
Can we watch a movie, Dad?
I brought you brisket.
You hear that? The kids want to watch a movie. Oh, my goodness. Oh, man, that's funny. One thing I always remember is there's always going to be interruptions when you're working, so it's hard to find a good time to draw without any interruptions. But when you can't, you just gotta take whatever moment you can. That includes that brief moment when you know your wife is taking the kids out for a little bit of a break, Sunday break. So, sorry about the interruption. Sorry about all the noise in the background, guys. Just kids. Thank you. Gotta check one thing in my book here for a second. I lost reference point. So, from the first book, this character is supposed to be a transmetamorphosis of one of the prattle fairies, and you can see her right. Where did it go? Page. Here we go. Alright. So, if you can see, it's one of these little characters right here. They're flying around. And they gave him, the foreigner, the ability to speak in different languages. So, I gotta. Figure out what I did for these characters back then. Okay, so there's little tattoos on the neck, so that's what I wanted to do with this one. Let's go ahead and complete her foot. Kind of see, I already laid down the rough draft of what I kind of had in mind. I'm gonna obviously alter it as I see fit. So again, my apologies for the background noise. Kids just came back home and they're pretty cranky right now. First day of school for them, so yeah, they're a little bit wound up. Back to school. Okay. So this is kind of what I had in mind. This is based off of one of the Kickstarter tiers. This person wanted to have the character drawn based on their spouse, and they sent me excellent reference materials, and I just wanted to use those ideas to pitch off of a character who the main character meets towards the end, and she basically reveals to him his issues and basically saves him from self-destruction. Like I showed you a little bit in that character in the book, this is one of the translator fairies, which helps the main character Kaz speak the tongue of Ravenica, and she gets becomes a part of Kaz, and then once Kaz falls ill, and then she isolates, she sacrifices her old self to become the new transformed version. And I'm really excited about it. I can't wait to show this to the backer. Thrilled to have this opportunity to draw this character. There's gonna be a couple more characters in the book that will be introduced. I just wanted to get this thing out of the way because it just so happens that this is a wedding anniversary present for one of the backers, and I just wanted to get this out as quickly as possible to these people. A little bit one day late, a couple days late, I think. I apologize about that. Sorry about that, a little car alarm. That's annoying. That's what happens when you live in Brooklyn. And to the backer who this character is commissioned off of, thank you so much for your support. I couldn't have done it without the generosity of you guys. I can't wait to show you this. This is going to be awesome. It's going to look awesome in color. Stay tuned. I'll do a hand sketch version of this illustration now that I have a pretty good idea of how I want the character to be like. I'm going to be doing a hand sketch version of this in a signed copy of a hardcover of The Foreigner. This is the first book of it, and I'll get it to ASAP, hopefully by within the middle of this week. So again, I apologize, a little bit, couple days late. But I really wanted to take some time in to make sure I nailed this character down. This is the first time, doing the Kickstarter working, not to come up with excuses, but it's kind of hard when you got kids shouting in the background. So this was like the only time I could do it. Hey Pamela, how's it going? Sure, this is something called Clip Studio Paint. And it's basically what Clip Studio Paint is it's a version of Photoshop that's specifically geared for comic book artists. So, you know, it'll have all the tools, which are supposed to emulate the traditional comic book artists, traditional tools like the pen and the brush, the ink brush, the Crokle pens, and so on and so forth. The one of the things I love about this is you don't have to tweak any of the tools. It comes right out of the box, all set to go. Super straightforward, intuitive. And also, if you guys know of anybody who is interested in pursuing art as a freelance or profession, this thing is very, very economic friendly. Meaning it's like 80, I can't remember, I think the base model is $80. $80 versus $35 or more for Photoshop a month. Which I think is ridiculous. There's no reason that Adobe needs to be charging so much money for that. You think about the art, the poor art kids these days. I mean, when I can relate to it a little bit, but although it's been a while, you know, it's not expensive, it's not cheap. Yeah, I was like, first, I was like, $80 a month. $80 flat fee. Sign me up. I don't have to worry about those ridiculous monthly fees. There's no reason to charge poor kids that, you know, art students that much. I'm gonna try something new with this character since I love Art Nouveau lines and a couple of artists I really like. They kind of use them a lot, and I'm trying to see if I can take some of that and make it my own. Okay. So I'm not quite sure what name I'm going to give this character. I might ask the backer to give a name. If she has any preferences. I initially put a name on the title of this description, but it's kind of like a last minute thing. I'm not quite sure if I'm going to stick with it. Alright, so this is kind of a good stopping point. I'm going to go ahead and take a quick stop here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to post this on, get rid of a sketch back layer back there. I'm going to post this on my YouTube channel. If you go to KensukeART on YouTube, you can find the full video of this. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I appreciate all your support. Thank you, all you backers and everybody who have made this whole Kickstarter, the Foreigner book possible. Don't forget, you can still order book one on my website, theforeigner.com. I'm sorry, theforeignercomic.com, or my website KensukeART.com. We're doing free shipping right now. And for a limited time, you can get the softcover or hardcover for both the same price. Also, you can also purchase the webcomic, the printed webcomic version of the series called The Rise. It explains the origins of the characters of the Foreigner. Origins basically meaning is the story behind the characters prior to book one, to give readers just a little more background of the plot. So you can check it out there as well. All right. Thank you so much, guys. Have a wonderful week. I'll talk to you soon. All right. Bye.